ZBrushCore's surface noise allows you to add different effects to your model to make it look like stone, wood, or various other materials. To use surface noise, first start ZBrushCore and load in a project. I'm just going to load this file right here. Once this is loaded in, simply navigate to the tool palette over here and open up the surface noise. ZBrushCore ships with a variety of different surface noises you can apply to your model. To access these, simply click on the Lightbox to Noisemakers button. Once you click this button, Lightbox will be opened up, and you'll be taken to the folder that contains all the noises. In here, there is a wide range of noises that you can apply to your mesh. To load a noise, simply hover over it and double-click. This will then apply that noise to your model. We can now hide Lightbox by clicking this button here or pressing comma on our keyboard. And now we'll see our model with that surface noise applied. To apply a new noise, simply go back to the surface noise panel, click that Lightbox to Noisemaker, and you can simply select another one. The surface noises that apply to your model are in a preview mode. What this means is that if you come down and grab any of the sculpting brushes and start sculpting on your model, you'll be able to sculpt on a mesh that looks like the surface noise you have applied. You can use smoothing effects, and any of the even large scale effects like the move brush. This is very handy in sculpting because you can apply a different surface to your model and then sculpt to get a different effect. If you'd like this surface noise to become part of your model, you simply need to navigate back to the surface noise panel over here and click the Apply to Mesh button. This will take the surface noise and bake it into the surface of your mesh. In addition to just using surface noises that are pre-generated in Lightbox, you can also create your own. To create your own surface noise, just simply click this Noise button, and this will open up Noisemaker. In here, you'll see a representation of your mesh, and you'll have a bunch of different sliders on the side. You can adjust variables like the noise scale. You can also set the strength to how this noise will look when it's applied to your mesh. In addition to just applying basic noise, you can also use the noise plug. When you click Noise Plug, this will open up another window. In here, you have a wide range of different effects you can apply to your mesh. You can select one of these here, and then hit OK, and then come over here and play with the strength, and you'll see that effect being applied. You can change the scale and get different results on your mesh. Also, modifying the graph will change how this noise will affect your mesh. You can also modify the presets. So if you click the Lightbox to Noisemaker button again, let's just select one to modify. We'll select this Noise 36, then we're going to hide Lightbox, and now under the Surface Palette, we're going to hit Edit. You're going to get that preview of your mesh again, but now you have that noise applied. So now we can change the scale, and change the strength, and different variables inside the plugin here. So using surface noise inside of ZBrushCore will allow you to give different effects to your model and still allow you to sculpt on them. So if you would like to sculpt on a model and have it look like stone or other materials, surface noise is the way to go. For additional tutorials on ZBrushCore, please visit ZClassroom.